soil particles in a soil mass experience a weight of everything above them, which includes weight of all the soil particles above them, weight of water, and weight of structure if present. And because of that, soil particles experience stress in between each other, which we call total stress. But if we put this soil mass in water, then because of buoyancy force, the net total downward force is reduced. Consequently, the stress on the particles is reduced. This reduced stress is called effective stress. The stress exerted by the water present in the soil pores is called pore water pressure. We can write expression for effective stress as total stress minus pore water pressure. Effective stress is different at different depths below the ground surface, because total stress and pore water pressure changes at different depths. We will try to calculate the effective stress at different plane sections in the soil while considering different water table levels. If level of water table in the soil changes because of any external factors like rain or overburden pressure, the movement of water takes place inside the voids present in the soil mass. This state of movement of water inside the soil is called hydrodynamic state or transient state of water. For now, we will discuss only hydrostatic conditions when no movement of water takes place in the voids. So let's consider this soil mass, in which the position of water table is at one depth below the ground surface. Soil below the groundwater table is fully saturated and has a unit weight gamma set, gamma saturation. While soil above the water table may not be completely dry, hence its unit weight is considered bulk unit weight gamma. We will try to find out the effective stress at this point or plane under the soil. Stress at any point or plane under the soil can be given as the force on that plane divided by the area of that plane. Force on that plane is the weight of soil above the plane, and that is the unit weight of soil multiplied by its volume. Volume is area multiplied by the height of the soil mass. This can be simplified to this. Hence, we can directly write this stress under any material as its unit weight multiplied by the height of the material above that point. So, on this plane, total downward stress is equal to the stress because of soil and water above it. Depth of unsaturated soil layer is assumed H1, and let the plane where we are calculating the stress is at depth H2 from the water table. Hence, total stress on this plane because of this not saturated soil mass is gamma H1. And stress due to saturated soil mass is gamma set H2. We should note here that gamma set already includes the weight of water present in the soil mass. Now, the pore water pressure at this plane is because of the water present above this plane up to the height of H2. So, pore water pressure on this plane is gamma W, unit weight of water, H2. Hence, we can calculate the effective stress on this plane in the soil as total stress minus pore water pressure. By writing the corresponding values, we get this. And by rearranging it, we can also write it as this. And if we remember, this quantity is called submerged unit weight of soil. So this is the expression for the effective stress on this plane in the soil. Now, if the water table rises to the ground, the whole soil deposit becomes completely saturated, and total stress at this plane is now caused by the whole saturated soil mass, which we can write as saturated unit weight of soil multiplied by the total height of the soil mass. And pore water pressure here becomes a unit weight of water multiplied by the height of soil deposit. Hence, effective stress can be calculated as this. And again, we can write this as submerged unit weight of soil. We know that submerged unit weight of soil, gamma prime, is less than bulk unit weight, gamma, because of the buoyancy factor. So here, if we compare this result with the result we received in our initial situation, we can note that because of the rise in the water table, the effective stress on the particles at a particular depth decreases. In another case, if the water table falls below our observation plane, then pore water pressure becomes zero, as no water present in the voids to apply pressure. And total stress will be the effective stress, which is the bulk unit weight of the soil multiplied by the height of the soil mass. Again, if we compare this result with the result of our initial situation, we observe because of the water drawdown, the effective stress has increased. Now consider a different soil condition, where soil mass consists of two different soil deposits which have different bulk unit weights, gamma 1 and gamma 2. We will calculate the values of effective stress at different sections of this soil deposit with different hydrostatic conditions. Let us begin by imagining the water table is above the soil mass and is of height H0. The soil becomes saturated. So their bulk unit weight become gamma sat 1 and gamma sat 2. Thickness of top layer is H1 and bottom layer is H2. We start calculating the effective stress on this plane section at the surface of the soil. On this plane, the downward stress is caused by the weight of above material, which here is water only. So total stress on this plane is unit weight of water multiplied by the height of water layer above this plane section. Now the pore water pressure on this plane caused by the water above is the unit weight of water multiplied by the height of the water. Hence, effective stress on this plane is total stress minus pore water pressure. Both are equal, so effective stress is zero. We can also visualize this situation, as we know that effective stress is the stress transferred at the contact of soil particles. But in our example, above our plane of consideration, there are no soil particles present. So no interparticle force transfer, hence effective stress on this plane is zero. Now move down a little and let us calculate the effective stress at this plane section, which is at H1 prime, depth below the actual soil surface. Total stress on this plane section is caused by the above water layer and this soil mass. Stress caused by the water layer is gamma W multiplied by H0, and stress caused by this saturated soil layer is gamma sat H1 prime. We should again keep in mind that water present in the soil voids will also cause to generate the vertical downward stress on this plane because of its weight. But in the calculation of total stress, we have taken the saturated unit weight of soil. That includes the weight of soil particles and weight of water as well. Now pore water pressure at this plane is because of the whole water available above this layer, which is gamma W multiplied by the whole height of the water surface, H0 plus H1 prime. Hence, effective stress can be calculated by total stress minus pore water pressure. And it can also be written as this. If we need to calculate the effective stress at this plane, where the two soil layers meet each other, the expression for the effective stress will remain the same. And only the depth of our observation plane from the soil surface, which is the only variable here, changes to H1, which is now the depth of our new observation plane from the soil surface. Now let's move downward a little more and calculate the effective stress on a plane somewhere in the middle of bottom layer. Let's say the depth of the observation plane in the bottom layer is H2 prime. Total stress on this plane is stress due to this water, gamma W H0, stress due to this saturated top layer, gamma sat 1 H1, and stress due to this much saturated bottom soil layer, gamma sat 2 H2 prime. Pore water pressure on this plane is gamma W and total height of the water. So, effective stress can be calculated as this, which is also written as this. If we need to calculate the effective stress at this plane section, that is, at the bottom of the bottom soil layer, the expression for the effective stress will again remain the same, and only the depth of our observation plane, H2 prime, which is the only variable here, changes to the thickness of the soil layer, H2. Hence, with all our calculations, we observed that change in the water level above the ground does have no effect on effective stress, and it remains unchanged. As we can see, the height of the water above the surface is not in any equation, because increased height of the water above the ground level causes to increase the total stress as well as the pore water pressure. Now let's discuss the case when water level has dropped to the soil surface. Of course, on the plane section at the surface has nothing above it and total stress is zero, so is the pore water pressure. Consequently, effective stress at this section is zero. Now let us calculate the effective stress on this plane where these soils meet each other. We can also take this plane anywhere in this soil layer, but result will be similar and only depth of our observation will change. Total stress on this plane due to the saturated soil layer above, gamma sat 1 H1. And pore water pressure is gamma W H1. Hence, effective stress can be calculated as this. Here, this can also be written as submerged unit feet. Now, on the plane section at the bottom of the soil deposit, the total stress is due to saturated soil layer above, gamma sat 1 H1 plus gamma sat 2 H2. Pore water pressure at this section is gamma W H1 plus H2. So again, we can calculate effective stress, which can also be written as this. Now water level in the soil has dropped and water table is now somewhere within the top layer of the soil mass. Again, we will calculate the effective stress on these different sections. At the top layer, as we have already seen, there will be no stress and effective stress is zero. Now at this level, total stress is the sum of stress due to the soil above this plane, which is both saturated and not saturated. Stress due to not saturated part of soil is bulk unit weight of soil, gamma 1, multiplied by the height of the unsaturated soil, say H1 prime, and stress due to saturated part of the soil, gamma sat 1, multiplied by the height, say H1 double prime. Pore water pressure at this section is gamma W and height of the water, H1 double prime. So again, effective stress can be calculated simply as this. And again, this can be written as this. Now, if we calculate the effective stress at the bottom of the second layer, total stress at this layer is unit weight of unsaturated soil 1, gamma 1 into H1 prime plus stress due to this saturated soil, gamma sat 1 H1 double prime plus stress due to this whole saturated soil layer, gamma sat 2 H2. Pore water pressure will be because of this water layer, that is gamma W H1 double prime plus H2. Hence, simply we can calculate the effective stress. And we can also write it in submerged unit weight of soil. Now, we assume the water level has dropped even further and the water table is now somewhere within the bottom layer of the soil mass. Effective stress on the surface will be zero. And now the stress at this plane where soil deposit meet will only because of unsaturated soil layer above. So total stress at this plane is bulk unit weight of soil gamma 1 multiplied by thickness of layer H1. No water is present above this plane, so pore water pressure is zero. So simply effective stress will be equal to total stress. Finally, we calculate the effective stress at this bottommost plane section. Total stress on this plane is a stress due to top unsaturated soil layer gamma 1 H1 plus stress due to this much unsaturated soil deposit of thickness say H2 prime gamma 2 H2 prime plus stress due to this saturated soil deposit gamma set 2 H2 double prime thickness of the saturated soil layer. Here pore water pressure will be because of this much water gamma W H2 double prime. So effective stress can be simply calculated as this. Part of the equation can also be written as the submerged unit weight of bottom soil layer. If you like elementary engineering videos, you may support it on Patreon. You may also choose to write down daily learnings or express your creative self in Ease Homemade Diaries. Buy them at Professor or Amazon. Link is in the description. Read Effect of Water Table on Effective Stress on elementaryengineeringlibrary.com. Link can be found in the description. Thank you.